Hey, what's happening, everybody? Paul Ingram here with Collie Center. In today's video, I want to do a quick talk about the realities of empty hands versus knife. If you have been looking for some serious training when it comes to empty hands versus knife, or knife defense, or knife self-defense against knife attacks, real knife attacks, you may not really like what I'm going to be saying in this video. All right, so you might want to turn away or just hit the thumbs down button right now if that's what you're looking for. But if you're looking for the truth, if you're looking for honesty from somebody that's been training with a knife, that's been using a knife, that's been carrying a knife with them for their pretty much their entire life, then hit the thumbs up button and let's get into it. So first of all, why am I making this video? You know, I've been seeing a lot of stuff going on, a lot of promotional stuff when it comes to empty hands versus knife. Or knife defense, defense against real life knife attacks, all these, you know, this type of things, you know, and people are looking at these things. And I was going through some of my old YouTube videos and stuff, some of the stuff where, you know, we're showing some empty hands versus knife stuff, and, you know, people are commenting that, you know, if this would work or this would not work. The first thing that I want to say is that the stuff that we put on YouTube, especially when it comes to like empty hand versus knife, or empty hand versus a bolo, or anything that's empty hands versus a weapon, I highly encourage you to go back to the very first video I ever uploaded here on the Collie Center channel. Because in that video, I clearly state that what we're putting out on the YouTube channel is not all necessarily about functional fighting. It's not about actual practical application. That a lot of the stuff that we're putting on YouTube for a general public audience is just for fun. It's for informational purposes. It's, you know, things that I learned across the board in just isolated Filipino martial arts. So with that said, the reality of empty hand versus knife, there isn't a program, really. I mean, there's not enough material out there to really make an empty hands versus knife fighting program. There's a reason why I have not made an empty hand versus knife program. I've made knife fighting programs. I've made stick fighting programs. I've made double stick programs and the spotty adaga programs and hit these different areas of Kali. But when it comes to the subcategory of Kali of empty hands versus knife, I have not made an actual full course program. And the reason being is that, well, there's really not a whole lot of information when it comes to empty hands versus knife, or knife self-defense, right? Self-defense against a real knife attack. When we take a look at a knife, I mean, it doesn't matter what the knife is, right? It could be this fixed blade here. It could be this little folding knife right here. It doesn't really matter what it is. The knives don't have to be very sharp. It does not take a lot of skill, a lot of effort to do lethal amount of damage to another person or anything when it comes to these little tools. Back in the day, the knife was used as a personal utility, or it was used as a tool of assassination, right? Or a tool of self-defense, but the knife was used in self-defense against somebody who was bigger or more skilled or more aggressive than you were. Then you would resort to the knife. So when you look at the knife, like when we take a look at the knife, when you have the knife in the forward grip, the primary strategies of the knife in the forward grip is either A, you are fighting knife versus knife, which is extremely dangerous, extremely difficult, and extremely high risk. Or it's possibly because you're looking to attack or counterattack somebody else who is preferably empty hands. If they do have a weapon, you're looking to ambush attack that person, you know, what we call like stealth kills or things like that. When you see the knife in the reverse grip, this is primarily for when, you know, this is primarily for going against somebody who is empty hands. You have the weapon and your knife is used for empty hands, or it's used for weapon retention, which is a secondary to like your firearm or, you know, whatever your primary weapon is. Okay. That's really what the knife is designed for as far as fighting goes. It is not in, you know, you're in an open area and you're going to duel it out. Especially nowadays, there's not a whole lot of knife duels. Even back in the day, there was not a whole lot of knife duels. It was mostly sword duels, right? And then later on in the Westerns, right, there were the revolver duels and things like that. But when it comes to empty hands versus a knife, the reality is that if you're not training knife to knife, if you're not learning how to knife fight with a knife and learning how to fight knife versus knife or knife versus other weaponry, then there is no program, there is no training empty hand versus knife that is going to help you. If you do not understand how to athletically move with a knife, if you don't understand the interaction, the strategy, the tactics behind the knife, knife versus knife, the aggression of the knife, the speed of the knife, the power and the lack of power needed with a knife, then again, there is no empty hand versus knife or knife self-defense program that is going to help you. In that regards, when it comes to real empty hands versus knife, or forget the term empty hand versus knife because it really doesn't exist. If you happen to be empty hand versus a knife, the only things that we have in Kali is really enough, just enough to get you hopefully out of the situation or to get you to a weapon. We never advocate you going in empty hands and trying to defeat a knife aggressor empty hands. If the person with a knife knows what they're doing, they are trained, they've got footwork, they understand strategy, they understand tactics, they know exactly what the knife does do, not just what it can do, you're out of it. If I had Tom attack me with a knife and I was empty hands, with all the training that I have, I would fail miserably. There is no way I would be able to defend myself against somebody like Tom who is attacking me empty hands versus a knife. I'm gonna get stabbed, I'm gonna get cut, and it's probably gonna be fatal for me. The best I would probably be able to do is maybe try to take him out with me. Again, that would be mutual destruction, so again, it's not successful. But that's the reality. I mean, you know, I've trained Tom to a point where, you know, it's a trust thing now, right? Like there's no way I would be able to protect myself against him attacking me empty hand versus a knife. It would never happen. If I was to attack Tom empty hand versus knife, again, there's nothing he can do. I mean, when it comes to highly skilled, trained people that this their profession is edged weapons, there's nothing you're going to be able to do. They got the strategy, they understand the tactics, they've got the athleticism, they understand how to navigate the terrain. They got the game plan down, you know, and there's not much you can do. If you are really concerned about defending yourself against a knife welding attacker, number one, I would definitely be working on awareness development. Make sure you are really training awareness, train observation of your environment. You have to be able to train the awareness and the observation of attacks or the potential of attacks, and train in other weaponry. Make sure that you are training in at least an equal weaponry, so it would be a knife versus knife. Make sure you are training in a superior weapon when it comes, you know, against the knife. Any kind of longer weapon, get firearms training. All that stuff, you know, get your CCW if you live here in the States, and you know, you can get that if you agree with it or not, doesn't really matter. But if you are serious about learning how to defend yourself against a knife welding attacker, you need to go more than just empty hands. Anybody that is selling courses or seminars or anything that is specializing in empty hands versus a knife or, you know, knife defense, I mean, purchase the program if you're interested in seeing what that information is, but take it with a grain of salt. The reality is, testing these techniques in a dojo, which is the most responsible thing that we can do as modernized civilian, you know, human beings, you're never going to find the reality of any kind of defense tactics and strategies against a knife. Training this stuff in a dojo with rubber knives or aluminum training knives or even shock knives, because when you get hit with a knife, okay, it doesn't shock you. Okay, I've been cut with knives. I've had to go to the hospital from training with live blades and get stitches and all kinds of things. Every single person on my staff has been to the ER. It's not something that we're proud of. It's just something that happens when, you know, you're training at staff level. All staff members have trained with live blades. We've all been cut. We've all cut ourselves, unfortunately, with time to time, and we've all, unfortunately, cut each other. And thank God it has not been anything super, super serious. We do the best that we can to take care of that, you know, in our training and things. But when you get hit with a real knife, you don't get shocked. So a shock knife is not going to give you reality. The closest thing would be probably training with an aluminum trainer. You know, you might feel a little bit of like a kind of like a bite if it kind of gets down into the bone area. But in reality, in my experiences of being cut and things, you can feel the skin kind of tear, but you don't really know really what the severity of the wound is until you look at it. You know, I've been cut on the forearm and things, and I've looked down to where, you know, you can see the bone. I mean, you can see the tendons in there, and had to go to the ER, get it cleaned up, get it stitched up, all that stuff. But when it comes to that, you know, the reality, training the reality of the knife, you're not going to get that in pressure testing this stuff in a dojo. Unfortunately, you're just not. The only way to really know if you have skills empty hand versus a knife is to be in that scenario. So anybody that's out there really claiming that they have a program that's going to teach you empty hand versus knife and that it's been pressure tested, I guarantee you they have not been to, you know, places in the world, Cuba, where, you know, in dealing with people with, you know, pressure testing against real, you know, Cubans that are professionals at drawing a knife. The Cubans have the best knife draws I have ever personally seen. They have not been to Spain. They have not been to, you know, the Philippines. They have not been in a knife situation. They probably never really had a knife pull out on them, you know, in a real situation before. It's a scary thing. And you're not going to pressure test any kind of empty hand versus knife stuff in a gym with foam weapon, foam knives, rubber training knives, aluminum training knives, shock knives. It's just not going to happen. So again, when it comes to your training with a knife or against a knife welding attacker, the reality is, and the truth is, and this is me speaking from somebody who has been literally carrying a knife with them since they were 9 years old, out hunting squirrels, you know, fishing, filleting fish, and then training, beginning my knife training in Filipino martial arts when I was 15 years old. My Filipino martial arts training began with a knife. And we had hickory oars is what we used for training. We didn't even have rattan training sticks at that time. I didn't even know that aluminum training knives even existed yet at that time in my life. But being somebody that has been in the field training with this stuff, live blade training, have been cut, been to the ER, having to get stitches. If you want to train any kind of defense against a knife, you need to, one, train how to knife fight. You need to train your footwork. You need to build up your athleticism. You need to understand the proper attribute development. You need to understand blade fighting strategies. You need to understand the tactics of what a knife actually does do, not just what it can do, but what it does do. And you need to go beyond the knife. You need to get to superior weapon categories. And in today's world, you should be definitely training with firearms if you are worried about, you know, protecting yourself or your loved ones against a knife wielding attacker. The reality is you need to open up the distance. You need to get to your firearm or some sort of superior weaponry, and you need to get a clean shot or multiple shots. One shot, you know, if you're carrying a 9mm, it may not be enough to stop that knife attacker. Most knife attacks happen 0 to 8 feet. That is the length or the width of one parking lot, one parking space. A few years ago, when I was doing a knife fighting, a knife combat knife weekend seminar, we were doing a test to see what the average knife draw was in speed versus the average person clearing that 0 to 8 feet distance, one parking spot width. And the average knife draw, no matter what knife they had, if it was a manual open, and we did all folders because folders are pretty much, for the most part, statewide legal to carry, different sizes and things, but not all places can you carry a fixed blade. So we did folders. We had manual folders just like mine. We had folders with the wave feature. We had spring assisted, all kinds of folders. It did not make a difference. The knife draw only matters, is only as fast as you can get the knife out, clicked, and secured in the grip. The most important part of the knife draw is that it is secured in your grip. Not necessarily that you're right here and your knife clicked. It's not complete. It's gotta be secured in the grip. And the average knife draw was 2.75 seconds. Out of all the fancy gadgets, all the different, we had Spyderco's, we had Emerson's, we had Benchmade's, we had Cold Steel, all of them. The average human sprint, starting from just a relaxed state, they had to go when somebody else told them to go, and they had to sprint, get across 8 feet distance. The average time on that was exactly 1.75 seconds. 1 second faster than the average knife, folding knife draw. So that would tell you that if you're going empty hands versus a knife, the only thing that you have is to clear that knife or get your footwork activated so you are off the path of that attack and get out of dodge and open up that distance. You know, we talk about isolation and all that stuff, isolating the knife and all that sounds great. And you may have to try to go for that. I'm not going to disclude that. But it's going to happen very, very quickly. You literally have maybe up to 3 seconds to isolate that actual knife. Just like if you're in a knife fight, knife versus knife, once that engagement happens, you've got within 3 seconds to get that shot in and make it effective. And even then, it may not stop or slow that attacker down. If you got a firearm and you draw that firearm and you know you got something like a 9mm or what and you put that round in them and they're already closing that distance and they're 2 feet away, you might be eating that knife in your chest or somewhere. So this is why you have to train weapon versus weapon. You need to train knife versus knife so you understand the importance of footwork and you understand the speed of which you need to execute that footwork. I've heard people talk about, oh, you don't need athleticism. You need to understand distance and timing. Yes, you do. But to improve your distance, to improve the control of that range, the control of navigation, to improve your calculation and regulation of timing, you need to increase your athleticism. That is what you have to do. You have to go out there, you have to train weaponry, you have to get your fitness in, you gotta go for runs, you gotta train your footwork in football length fields. You know, you have to do the work. That is the only thing that is going to protect you. That is the only thing that's going to help you build the awareness and build the observations when it comes to knife defense or knife self-defense or thinking of anywhere along the terms of empty hands versus a knife. You're not going to catch an arm. Do not take the fun informational videos that I've put here on YouTube. Don't take those as serious, functional, practical, empty hand versus knife videos. They're not. They are not. I am the first person to say that. All right, they are just fun training videos. They're fun techniques to do with your buddies, right? And just have fun. If you want to get collie training, then you got to get in the programs. You got to get into, you know, our knife fighting program, which is going to teach you the basic handling skills of the knife. It's going to teach you the footwork, and it's teaching you to understand, at least at an academic level, of what the knife fighting actually entails, what the footwork, the demand on the footwork actually is. You know, understanding strategy, understanding tactics. You have to do the training. And this is why with our Inner Triangle program, we do meetups. We do training meetups that are complimentary to our Inner Triangle members. I'm going to be doing more of those coming next year. I'm going to be replacing my ITC camp with a specialized Inner Triangle training camp that I'm going to be starting in 2021. So I'm going to be focusing a lot of time with my Inner Triangle people because these are the people that really want to get the training. They're increasing athleticism. They want the academics. They want the physical performance of weaponry. And, you know, they don't want to just do this false thing of empty hands versus knife. You need to learn the full spectrum of blade weaponry. That's just the reality of dealing with edged weapons. It really is. I've rolled around with some good friends of mine who are black belts in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. I have a little bit of grappling experience outside of Kali, outside of our Dumog stuff. We're not the best grapplers in the world. BJJ, you know, Judo, Pankration, Sambo, these arts are masters at grappling, way over Kali. Kali, when it comes to our Dumog, it is good and you can specialize in it, but again, it's the purpose of the Dumog is a little bit different than, you know, the grappling that you see in BJJ or in, you know, typical, you know, Roman Greco wrestling or in Sambo or in Pankration or anything like that. It's a little bit different. It has a different purpose. But rolling around with some of my good friends, you know, BJJ black belts, judo black belts, I gotta tell you, man, like we have not found a good solution to empty hands versus a knife on the ground. And we've had a lot of very good brain power on there. And when the person with the knife knows what they're doing, you're, pardon my language here, but you're fucked. I mean, that's just the reality of it. Do not get on the ground when the person has a knife. You're in some serious trouble. It's going to be very difficult to just break their arm or anything like that. It may be possible. You may get it. I'm not going to say nothing is going to work. But it is a game of chance when you're looking at any scenario, empty hands versus a knife. Against a knife attacker that really knows what they're doing, if you're empty hand versus a knife, I would say you have less than 1% chance of surviving that situation, empty hand versus their knife attack. You know, you're using weaponry, you're starting to open up that percentage, you know, a lot more in your favor. You're able to open up the distance. You got a more higher caliber pistol. You are definitely increasing your chances, you know, your percentages of surviving that situation. That's just the reality. I wanted to put this video out here. I know it's a long-winded video. Hopefully you guys appreciate this video. It is 100% honest. You will not see me put together an empty hand versus knife fighting course or a knife defense course program, anything like that. You will not see it. All the empty hand versus knife stuff that we actually teach, that's the reality stuff that we teach, it's not a lot of information, guys. It really isn't. That's the reality of it. Most of the emphasis is going to be on footwork, understanding how to navigate that, you know, your terrain in that situation and getting yourself out of that situation and or getting to your weaponry. Anytime that we are sparring at the school and somebody loses their weapon, whether it's, you know, bolos or we're knife sparring or whatever it is, or we're doing empty hand stuff and somebody draws a weapon during the empty hand sparring, the person that loses the weapon or draws the weapon first and gets that shot in, they're the one who comes on top every single time. I mean, it's really, you know, if you're going empty hands versus a knife, you're going to be taking some damage. That's just the reality of it. If the person knows what they're doing, you're in some serious trouble. You know, if they understand how to manipulate the knife, you know, they understand what they're doing with one of these. They understand footwork. They've got strategy. They understand the tactics of how to manipulate this thing. Again, you're in a massive world of trouble. So, you know, I would never tell you what to buy, what not to buy, what to believe, what not to believe. You can completely think that everything I'm saying is complete garbage in this video. Whatever you want to believe, that is your opinion to believe. But being that I've been personally training with knives since I was 15 years old, so it's 20 years now. My this past June was my 20th year involved with edge weaponry training. You got the freedom to choose to believe and have your own opinions, you know, whatever it is you want to believe and the opinions that you want to have. But just be worried about it. Anybody that is claiming that they got a program for knife defense or they have a solution for empty hands versus knife, you know, and they got a full-blown course or they're teaching a full-blown weekend training camp on it or something like that. No, there's really not that much information when it comes to it. You know, when it comes to self-defense training really is the minimal requirement of martial arts training. It doesn't take a whole lot to be able to defend yourself, to be able to protect yourself. If you're looking to fight your empty hands versus somebody with a knife, good luck. That's all I have to say to you. You're not getting out of that situation either dead or with some serious life-changing injuries. And it's going to happen very, very quickly. Faster than what you think. And it's not going to be the same feeling and the same result as when you're in the dojo training with rubber knives and aluminum knives and shock knives. It's going to be a very, very different result. So, I don't know. Tell me your comments below. What do you think about empty hands versus a knife? What do you think about the things that I'm saying in this video? What do you think about the things that you're seeing out there, you're hearing from other people, maybe you've experienced in the world? You know, some things work, but they're probably not training those things against people who I would say are, who have been dedicating their life to edged weaponry martial arts. So, yeah, love to hear your guys' thoughts. If you're new to the channel, hit the subscribe button, hit the thumbs up button. If you appreciate this little chat, I wanted to get this out there because when we're talking about the world of self-defense, you know, empty hands versus knife is just one of those things that out of my 20 years of training Filipino martial arts, we have not found a real solution other than a very small amount of information that has been giving us consistent results and has... It has nothing to do with actually trying to engage the person with the knife. It's really about having a strategy, tactics, techniques that follow those strategy and tactics to really open up distance and get yourself out of dodge. Or get yourself to a weapon. I mean, that's just the reality of when it comes to weapons, especially edged weapons. There's little room for error when it comes to edged weapons. You know, the knife does not have a line of sight. It does not run out of ammo. It doesn't have emotions. It doesn't care. It doesn't have feelings. It doesn't need to be very sharp. You know, I could dull this knife out, right? I mean, if you ever heard of like people getting stabbed with screwdrivers and things like that, I mean, it doesn't take much. So, you know, you can do a lot of damage to somebody with just a ballpoint pen, a Bic pen. You don't need a tactical pen. You don't need to go out there and spend $50 on a tactical pen. Just go get a, you know, spend $1.99 and you got 100 Bic pens and they're gonna work just as well if you want, you know, to understand a pen. That's a whole nother conversation. All right, guys, I'm out of here. I'll see you soon and happy training. Most important thing is train smart, train safe, be smart. Know what's real when you're watching a YouTube video and know what's just for fun, okay? Be intelligent here. I would hope that majority of martial artists can watch a video and they can see that a technique is just, it's just on video for All right, guys, I had to switch to my phone real quick because my other camera ran out of memory. But just in closing with this video here, guys, Look, I know that there's an ad out there going around that's got, you know, one of the Collie Center clips from one of our old videos and stuff that, you know, and I've getting emails and like, oh, this person used our clip and whatever, and claiming that, look, I'm not going to hate on somebody that is, you know, trying to do their thing, got their hustle going, trying to make a little, you know, some money, you know, their living, whatever it is. All right. I'm not going to sit there and report it or anything like that. I really don't give a shit about it. Hopefully you guys are smart enough. I would imagine that most martial artists in the world nowadays are intelligent enough to know the difference between a video that is displaying a technique that is just for fun versus something that is for functional, real application purposes in the world. So if you are not smart enough to identify that, especially here on the Collie Center, because we do make our videos, we make them, you know, if you can read between the lines of how we make our videos, you know, what is kind of more a serious training video and what's just kind of a fun technique video. If you can't read between those lines here, you know, watching our videos, then you probably don't fall into the category of the intelligence that I'm thinking that maybe you have. That's not an insult. It's just what it is. But hopefully, you know, hopefully you guys are smart enough to understand the difference. Like I said, a lot of our videos here that we do on Collie Center on the YouTube channel, these are not videos to go out there and think you're going to go fight the world and fight knives and empty hands versus knives and survive combat situations. And, you know, you're going to be like, you know, the Collie Rambo or whatever it is. These videos are for fun. They're for training Collie at an educational purpose, a fun recreational purpose, right? I don't train anymore for self-defense. I train for fun. It's a recreation of mine. I enjoy the movement. I enjoy the health benefits of Collie. It keeps my body fit. It keeps my mind sharp. And that's really what I enjoy training my Collie for. You know, it's kind of like a moving meditation for me nowadays. If you're looking for self-defense, more type of training, you're really not going to get it. Going to get that from our YouTube channel. You got to get in the program of our Inner Triangle, and you got to come and actually train with us in person. You got to get out to the ITC. You got to get out to our chapters. You got to come out to, you know, come out to see me, man. Come, you know, get in the Inner Triangle, train the programs. That's all weapon versus weapon. And then come out to the training meetups that are complimentary for you as an Inner Triangle member to come train. That's where you're gonna get it. Right? I mean, that's the truth. That's the reality of it. So whatever you're training, you know, whatever you're watching on YouTube, whatever you're training off of our videos, right, is there to give you a very basic understanding of how certain, you know, the sticks manipulate and how the footwork manipulates and all that stuff. All right, but it's not an in-depth, you know, it's not our curriculum. It's not any of that stuff. So, you know, whatever it is, it is. All right, I'll talk to you guys later on. So get out there, go train. I'll see you soon.